हेलो क्लास 5 साइंस. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द चैप्टर फूड एंड हेल्थ, द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ कम्युनिकेबल एंड नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेस. इन द लास्ट वीडियो आई हैव टोल्ड यू द वेरियस कॉजेज ऑफ कम्युनिकेबल एंड नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेस. नाउ टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू समथिंग अबाउट द प्रिवेंशन. How can we prevent ourselves from these communicable and non-communicable diseases? Now, as you know, what are communicable diseases? Communicable diseases are spread from one person to another. It means they are contagious. So, in order to stop spreading them, we should follow some guidelines. These guidelines are as follows. First of all, we should keep ourselves and our surroundings neat and clean. Wash hands before eating anything. Trim your nails regularly. Keep the garbage in covered bins. These are the some points. And we should take care of hygiene. Now, what do you mean by hygiene? Hygiene is the keeping ourselves and our surrounding neat and clean in order to stop spreading of diseases and stop spreading of diseases and prevent illness. This is the hygiene. Okay, so we should keep our hygiene very clean so that we should not get any kind of disease, because you all know these main diseases are spread due to germs, and for that we should keep our bathroom, kitchen and every place in our house very neat and clean. Bathroom should be cleaned regularly, and they should also be kept dry, because we know that germs mostly breed in damp and dark places. So in order to stop breeding of germs, we should keep our house very neat and clean. There should be proper ventilation of air in the house. Moreover, as we know that the sunlight is the main disinfectant of the germs. It is the natural disinfectant of the germs. So our house should be like this, that it should allow proper sunlight to come in, and the proper air should be there. And if still any kind of disease is spreading, we should take care, we should go to the doctor. And one thing very important, the vaccination. You know, government has immunization system. Now what they do, they vaccinate to children. Proper vaccination is given to them to prevent with very dangerous diseases. So vaccination is also one of the method to prevent communicable diseases. Now I come to non-communicable diseases. As we know, non-communicable diseases are due to the deficiency of some nutrient in our diet, in our food. So we should take all the nutrients. This is the only way to keep ourselves safe from the non-communicable diseases, that we should eat and we should take all the nutrients in our diet properly. And if there is still any kind of non-communicable diseases, like I told you in the last video, that there are some diseases which are due to the deficiency of vitamin A, vitamin B, C, D, E, iron and calcium and iodine. So we should check how to cope up with these deficiency. Like in case of iodine, if there is lack of iodine in our body, we should take iodized salt. And if we are suffering from anemia, it means there is deficiency of iron in our body. So we should take more leafy vegetables. Spinach is very good for, it has lot of iron in it. We should take dates, guavas, apples, bananas, especially the jaggery. Jaggery, you know what is jaggery? Jaggery is good. We should eat sufficient quantity of all these things. Again, if we are suffering from night blindness, we should take vegetables, mangoes, milk, potato, butter, the food which is rich in vitamin A, because night blindness is due to the deficiency of vitamin A. Similarly, if a person is suffering from beriberi, it means he or she is in deficient of his this thing, deficient of vitamin B. So he or she should take vitamin B in a large quantity, like unpolished rice, fish, meat, cereals. These all are very much rich in vitamin B. If any person is suffering with scurvy, it means he or she is suffering with the deficiency of vitamin C. So then he should take tomatoes, more of the citrus fruits, tomatoes, vegetables, oranges, amla, like these things. And even the sprouted grains and pulses are very good for scurvy patient. So these were the some of the examples of non-communicable diseases and how to cope, how to prevent ourselves with these diseases. So I think you have understood some of the very good preventive measure, how to safeguard ourselves with this communicable and non-communicable disease. So it is enough for today. So in the next video, I'll share some more things with you. Thank you so much. Take care.